After dawn services and marches in cities around the nation this morning, Australians are commemorating Anzac Day at marches in pubs and clubs. We've got our reporters live in Sydney and Darwin this afternoon. Firstly to Danica DiGiorgio at the Harbour Diggers on the northern beaches of Sydney. Danica, it's being billed as the biggest two-up event in the Southern Hemisphere.
And I tell you what, Kieran, I don't think that they're off the mark there. There are thousands of people here today. Have a look at this. They've just taken a break, but they have been playing two up for at least the next 3 hours. Yeah, you can see some very excited punters in the crowd there right now. They've been winning money, losing money all afternoon, but it doesn't matter. They're here to have a good time. These crowds have been building slowly for the last 3 hours. They say it's the biggest in the Southern Hemisphere. They also say to stick around for the next few hours because it's only going to get bigger. I spoke to the ringmaster. He's been at it all afternoon. I had a chat with him. He says it's even bigger than the biggest event in the Southern Hemisphere.
We hold the world's biggest two-up game. We've had some amazing events over the years, and every year it just gets better and better and better. So all new people, all new crowd, all new faces.
So not just the biggest in the Southern Hemisphere, but you're saying the biggest event in the world.
That's what they told me, yeah. Several years before COVID, they said they hit the peak, and I remember, I think some of the authorities went, it's getting a little bit too big, let's just calm it down a little bit.
Yeah, it's just started getting very loud back here. They've just restarted again. I caught up with a couple of veterans earlier who were here, and they told me how important this day is for them. What does this day mean to you?
A hell of a lot. This medal here is 116. Was my grandfather's service number, and my father was in the war. I was in Vietnam. All my uncles were in Korea and Borneo. My son was in Afghanistan.
This is the only time I throw the coin here. And I've never played two-up. My father never played two-up, and he was a ratter at Tobruk. I never played two-up in Vietnam, so I don't know what it's all about.
So, Kieran, the Harbour Diggers here was actually started by a World War One digger 80 years ago. So synonymous with Anzac Day and perfect weather for it as well.
Looks like a cracking day there for Anzac Day, and Matt Cunningham is at the Hotel Darwin. Matt, have you tried your hand at two up today?
Well, not yet, Kieran, but I did get into the middle of the circle here at the Hotel Darwin. I'll tell you what, if Danica reckons she has the biggest two-up event in the world, we've certainly got the most enthusiastic here at the Hotel Darwin. A bit of pressure, too, for those people who step into the ring and try and flip those coins. I saw one bloke go in there. He stuffed up the coin toss completely, and he got yelled out of there in about 5 seconds flat. So plenty of pressure when you're tossing those coins, but plenty of money being thrown around as well, Kieran. They reckon cash is dead. Well, it's not dead at the Hotel Darwin today. I've seen more $50 notes flying around since when Tony Barber was hosting Sale of the Century, I reckon. So it's all happening here now. A great atmosphere here at the Hotel Darwin. Everyone having a good time. There was a more sombre event this morning, of course, as thousands turned out at the Darwin Cenotaph to mark Anzac Day. And then we saw more than 5,000 people turn out in the Darwin CBD as the march passed through the city. This really is a defence town, and we're feeling that at the moment as well, Kieran, with those announcements yesterday from the federal government around the Defence Strategic Review and a real focus on the north. It is the only place in this country that has been the subject to a foreign attack back on the 19th of February 1942. We're right at the forefront again. This really is a defence town, and you're feeling it today here in Darwin.
Indeed, and you go and have a cold one and toast the veterans, my friend. We'll talk to you soon. Let's